In spite of the high abundance in the Earth's crust of silicon, this element is never found in nature as the free element, but only in compounds containing oxygen-silicon bonds. In the pure form, it's a grey, metallic-looking crystalline solid. However, it's not classified as a metal considering its low electrical conductivity. In addition, due that it possesses some of other properties similar to metal, sometimes this element is preferred to consider it as a semi-metal. The element can be prepared by different methods depending on the purity needed for further application. Currently, the most common method of producing silicon is similar to the original method described by Berzelius in 1808. This method, which is called metallurgical grade silicon process, consists on a metallurgical procedure in which silicon dioxide is reduced by heating it with coke and charcoal at over 2000 Celsius degrees in an electrical furnace. For this reaction, it is important to have an excess of silica in order to avoid the accumulation of silicon carbides, as it shows in the following equation. The high temperatures of the process ensure that the silicon obtained is in the liquid state because it has a melting point of 1400 Celsius degrees. Therefore, the liquid silicon can be drained from the bottom of the furnace and obtained with a purity of 98.99%. The resulting silicon is known as metallurgical grade silicon or Mg silicon, and it usually contains different impurities such as iron, aluminum, titanium, boron, chromium, and other metals. For some specific application, especially in semiconductor industry, it is necessary to obtain ultra-pure silicon. This means that impurity level should be below the parts per billion level, and therefore metallurgical grade silicon is not adequate. One of the most common processes to obtain pure silicon is the CMM process, which consists of heating Mg silicon obtained from the metallurgical process at 300 Celsius degrees in a current of hydrogen chloride gas in a fluidized bed reactor to form trichlorosilane, as is shown in the following equation. This process ensures that some of the impurities present in the crude silicon react with hydrogen chloride to form the corresponding halides, and considering the low boiling point of trichlorosilane, which is only 31.8 Celsius degrees, it would be possible to extract it by exhaustive fractional distillation until reaching the adequate purity level. The resulting ultra-pure trichlorosilane obtained is then reacted with hydrogen at 1100 Celsius degrees following this equation. The reaction takes place at the surface of a high purity silicon filament, which is therefore continuously covered with high purity silicon in the form of a fine-grained polycrystalline deposit. Interestingly, the hydrogen chloride obtained as byproduct in this reaction can be reduced in the first part of the process. Silicon produced by CMM's process is called semiconductor grade silicon, which usually has an impurity level of 1 part per billion or even less. However, polycrystalline silicon obtained from CMM's process could be even not useful for some applications such as highest efficiency solar cells or for making semiconductor devices such as integrated circuit used in computers, TVs, mobile phones, or other electronic devices. For these uses, it is necessary to employ single crystal silicon and to accomplish that there are two important technologies. The first process consists on melt the high purity semiconductor grade silicon in an atmosphere of argon and employ a single crystal rod as a seed to obtain a large single crystal of silicon. As it is shown in the following image, the rod is dipped into the molten silicon and slowly pulled upwards and rotated simultaneously. By this process, it is possible to obtain large single crystals in the same orientation as the original seed. This process is called Throckloski process, after the Polish scientist Jan Throckloski invented it in 1916. This process is widely employed in the industry of semiconductors for other materials such as germanium or gallium arsenide. In addition, it presents the advantage to facilitate the synthesis of N-type or P-type semiconductor by simply adding dopant impurities to the molten silicon. Throckloski process is the cheapest method to obtain the growth of large single crystals, although it is also has the disadvantage that the walls of the crucible made of silica dissolve into the melt during the process. Surprisingly, for some application, the impurity of oxygen can have beneficial effect, but for some other application, this process is not adequate. The second type of process, float zone process, produces more pure large single crystal of silicon than the Throckloski process. The process consists on handling vertically a rod of polycrystalline silicon within an argon atmosphere and attach a single crystal seed to one end. A high temperature electric coil melts the material in the zone where the seed is attached, and as the heating coil moves upwards along the rod, the molten zone also moves. When the silicon resolidifies, produce a single crystal with a determined orientation. This process has also the advantage to purify and refine the product due to on the fact that impurities are more soluble in the liquid phase than in its solid phase. This is what is commonly known as zone refining. So, as the heater moves, the impurity diffuses into the portion of the rod that it is still molten, and thus, once the entire rod has passed through the coil, impurities can be removed from the bottom of the rod. Finally, it is important to remark that these processes for obtaining semiconductor-grade silicon, such as Siemens process, are quite expensive and high energy demanding, and therefore there are alternative routes for refining MG silicon that show promising results for some other application which can tolerate a high amount of impurities. For example, for some crystalline silicon solar cells for which the purity requirements were not so high, a less purity but also less low-cost silicon can be employed to provide enough efficiency to the cells. With this type of silicon, which is called solar-grade silicon, it has been reported solar cell efficiencies in excess of 12%. Obviously, high efficiency solar cells greater than 12%, they are fabricated using wafers made of semiconductor-grade material. Therefore, according to the desired specification of the solar cell, the purification process will be developed in lower or higher grade.